certainly want to avoid what they had to do last possession. That was punt the football, because this game's starting to tighten up.
In a basketball sense, you think about taking a little bit of the air out of the ball, right? Maybe milk some clock, limit the possessions. In this case, they might want to do the same thing, but control the game offensively. Put together some first downs, put together a drive, and keep it away from them.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Throwing on first down, Stone. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
Well, I guess we just discovered that someone is certainly not going to sit back and just take it in this game, huh?
No, they were trying to get that touchdown back in one shot.
One shot, trying to help out his defense and let the other team know they were coming after him.
Line of scrimmage, the 31, as they line up second and 10.
Here we go now. Boom!
And they'll go with a ground attack here. Found a little room there as he's up to about the 37. They get six here after the incompletion, and it'll leave them with a third and four. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up at the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
Quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom, quick, and what a terrific play, holding them to no gain.
On now is the Titans punter. He's been terrific so far. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. And this is going to hit the goal line and continue on into the end zone for a touchback. The Rams offense now, they get set and head back onto the field. Last time they were out here, they had the benefit of good field position, led to a touchdown. This time, they're going to have to work for it.
They are, but with that last drive that culminated in a touchdown, I think they carry that confidence into this one. Doesn't matter where you start with the football now, they have to feel great about their opportunity.
Out of the gun, gone. And this will be broken up and incomplete. Now a penalty flag down, and they may be going backward here.
Holding offense.
Well, there have been a ton of sacks. They were just trying to prevent another.
So what you're telling me is the conventional way has not really worked for them, huh?
Not at all.
Not at all. So he tries to grab him here, and they still get caught.
Shotgun snap for Gong. And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. And he'll be about a full yard shy of the 20 at the 19-yard line. Give him nine there on the first down completion.
One of the advantages of zone defense, as I remember it, is being able to see the play develop in front of you. One of the disadvantages, when they find those levels where they can hit you with it, sometimes behind the corner and in front of the safety, it makes it tough to defend.
Here's Goff now on second down. And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's third. Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. Here's Goff. And he overshot him there. It's out of bounds, incomplete.
And you just know when that play call came in, their eyes lit up, because anytime you get a chance to take a big shot downfield, that's a lot of fun, and they missed an opportunity.
Fielded at about the 28. And he'll be out of bounds right at the 40. So a change of possession here on the punt. The Titan offense now working their way back onto the field. They punted last time they had it. What steps, Charles, do you think they have to take to make sure they don't do that again?
Well, let's just go to the football 101, the trite expression 101. Win first down. Make 5, 6, 7 yards on first down and make it a 2nd and 3, 2nd and manageable. Keep accumulating first downs that way. Keep moving the football. Don't want to get behind the sticks because then the defense has the advantage.
And he'll get this out past the 45 to the 47. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3. And he goes down right there. So the Titans in possession of the football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. As big of a play as we've had in this one so far. This is 3rd and 3.
Here we go now. Blue 90. Blue 90.
And they'll run it here. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. And now right out of the 2-minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with a minute 56 to go. The defense, they got a little bit of a breather. Now they're back and set as we resume play. On now is the Titans punter as he'll come on to kick this one away. And that'll hit in the end zone. Much too much leg there. That'll be a touchback. And the Rams getting set to go now. And last time out, they had to punt the football away. Anything positive possibly to take from that?
There always is when you're punting the football away. It doesn't sound like it because you're giving it up, but you've avoided a mistake.
At least you didn't turn it over.
You didn't turn it over, right? You're giving it, giving your defense a chance because you're punting the ball away and they're set to go on the field as opposed to sudden change after a turnover. And wow, now we got to go out there and stop people. So yeah, there's always something positive to be gained from it.
Looking right sideline, but it's incomplete. He was looking for Todd Gurley, and it's 2nd down. This defense has watched their lead dwindle away. This is where they really need to bow up. They executed well there.
And it's often hard after you've played really well early, and then you kind of relax a little bit, to step on the gas again. They just did it on the last play. Looks like they want to finish this one off.
Back to throw. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And the offense will get this one back. Boy, that could have been catastrophic at this late stage of the game, but they avoid disaster. That last completion, certainly not what they were hoping for, as now they'll try to convert on 3rd. They'll look to throw. And nearly intercepted there. That would have been ball game if he had clinched it and caught it. Instead, it gives him one more chance here on 4th down. Nearly an interception. If that one's picked off, it's over. So a new lease on life, so to speak.
A lot of times when you're in coverage, you're so focused on the man and the coverage that sometimes the ball, if it arrives, it surprises you. That may have happened to him in that situation.
And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off at the 30. And it's a tremendous return as they finally get him at about the 10-yard line.
And that one, oh, it's going to hurt big time. You're in the 2-minute drill trying to get your guys down the field, and it's looking like they're going to go up just short, as this is definitely not his best throw. and it'll wind up being intercepted.
It's first and goal, and a late touchdown at this stage could officially salt this one away. And they'll go ground game here with a tailback. So a nice job to break the one tackle, but not much daylight after that as he's brought down. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here as they get the stoppage with 65 seconds remaining. And the ball smack dab on the 5-yard line. Here's second and goal. To him up the middle. And he will push his way forward down to about the 3-yard line. And give him 2 yards officially, and now it'll be third and goal.
I have to laugh a little bit because he actually handed it off. I thought with the 2 touchdown passes he's thrown in this one already, he'd go ahead and fling and try and get a third one.
Yeah, now from this spot on third down, I think he'd probably throw
in
here.
Yeah, I don't think there's any question about it. They won't even send in a running play here, I don't believe. I think they go ahead and try and throw it for a touchdown.
And he's across for the touchdown. And in the final minute, that should just about seal it.
And that touchdown should make you feel comfortable. But do you really feel like it's totally over yet?
Not totally, but I think you're pretty much there.
Yeah, you still got to make sure you stay with it, do all the right things down the stretch, especially on defense. But that touchdown there, you got to feel good about your chances.
A try here for the extra point. Extra point splits the uprights, and the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. The drive there only spanning 3 plays. And it ends with a 3-yard scoring run. Kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The Titan defense getting set now, coming back onto the field. And the interception, the last time they were out there, ended up leading to a touchdown.
So the only thing they didn't get really was the pick six, because that's what everyone wants. Take it immediately to the end zone. But their offense capitalized on the takeaway and turned it into the 6 points they were looking for.
Yeah, shut them up pretty, got the touchdown. Now they're back out there defensively. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. Line of scrimmage, again the 25, second and 10. Second and 10, Goff again. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. Tried to go for the big one there on second down. Now they're likely down to their final 2 plays.
And you know they've got to keep going for the big shot, right? So defensively, you play what they call top down. Nothing behind you. Make everything get completed in front.
From the gun on third down, Goff. And that one drops to the ground, incomplete. Clock stops here, just inside of 20 seconds, 19 left.
And I think we'll probably see him go for it here on fourth down. No reason not to. Down a couple of scores, they have to try and make something good happen.
Desperation time for Goff on fourth. And that is incomplete. Down to 15 seconds now. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And that may write a finish to this Super Bowl. So with that, we can just about close the book on this one, Charles.
Yeah, what's the old expression about slim and none? Well, slim just left town on that one.
They're down to none.
Yes, exactly right.
Time for this one final knee to put a bow on this title bout. And they're singing in the Music City. The Tennessee Titans are your Super Bowl champions. And their remarkable season ends in the most remarkable of ways. They get to put next to their name, Super Bowl champion.
And they can't ever take that away, can they?
Nope.
That lasts forever. So good to see the emotion when it's all said and done. You see the hugs, you see the guys sharing, the collective happiness. Makes me want to carry you around a little bit on my shoulders to celebrate the triumph. And congratulations to them, a fantastic season.
Super Bowl champs, the Lombardi Trophy is theirs, and so are bragging rights for an entire season. What a season it has been. Feels like we have been there every step of the way. Our entire crew doing a wonderful job. Thanks to my broadcast partner, Charles Davis. For all those guys, I'm Brandon Gunn signing off. We'll talk to you next season right here on EA Sports.